Thank you, Mr. Stroop, for joining me this afternoon to talk about how Philip is progressing in the classroom. Anytime during this meeting that you have questions or comments, please feel free to let me know.
Thank you. I'm looking forward to hearing what you have observed.
I had the pleasure of spending time with Philip and his class on two occasions to view how the classmates were interacting with each other. By observing and using a checklist, I was able to mark off Philip's developmental progress.
What resource did you use for finding a developmental checklist?
That's a wonderful question. I used a developmental checklist adapted by First Look and the Early Childhood Direction Center, which is the one recommended to show age-appropriate developmental progress. This checklist is split into multiple domains to show each area to observe for children and their development.
What different areas did you observe?
The different areas I looked for my observation were fine motor, gross motor, social, emotional, cognitive, and language development.
What did your observations of Philip show you?
I will go through each domain and explain the goals that I was able to observe during my time with Philip. I will start with the fine motor skills. I was able to see Philip feed himself with a spoon during breakfast, as well as use several small instruments to make food for his friends in the sandbox during playtime. I was not able to observe many areas of fine motor development due to the time periods during the day that I did my observations, but I can suggest a resource to help you with fine motor skills. I would get a readiness book, which will give you some activities that you can let him practice at home. I would encourage the Highlights Preschool Workbook. This workbook would give you some wonderful, much-needed skill building to begin forming letters, shapes, and numbers. Next, we can talk about the gross motor skills. I was able to observe Philip reaching. He was able to walk up and down stairs, throw a ball over his head, and move back and forth. He seems to demonstrate a strong ability to reach movement goals. An activity that you can do at home to encourage physical growth would be to set up an obstacle course inside your house, which would encourage Philip to work with his physical skills. You can demonstrate the skills needed to complete the course and allow Philip to mimic your actions. As far as Philip's social skills, he was observed playing with multiple children, independently putting his jacket on, and using his imagination with his classmates. I would suggest that you continue to encourage his fantasy play. I found a great website that gives suggestions for home activities that you can do with your children to encourage this kind of play. Are you interested in getting that resource?
Yes, please. What is it?
Sure. It's todaysparent.com, which provides you with many different activities you can do with your young children. Philip's emotional development also demonstrates that he cannot always tell the difference between reality and fantasy. This is not something that you should be concerned about, because it is very normal and encouraged for children of his age to make up stories, have make-believe friends, or tell something that cannot be true. If you would like to encourage his storytelling skills, you can include Philip in making up his bedtime stories at night. This would not only be a way for you to spend a little extra time before bed with him, but it would also encourage him to use his imagination. Next, I was able to watch Philip demonstrate his cognitive development through his ability to recognize colors, count a few numbers, follow commands, tell about a personal experience, and demonstrate a fantasy story.
Do you feel like he needs to work any in this area?
Although I feel like children are constantly learning, I do not see any indication to be alarmed over the progress that Philip is currently making. You can continue to work with him on the areas that I was not able to observe him, such as his ability to understand time and knowing how to view items as the same and different.
Do you have any suggestions for improving in those areas?
I would also use the Highlights workbook that I suggested earlier to help in that area as well. The last area that I observed Philip was his language development. He was able to speak clearly with his classmates as well as the adults around him. I would suggest that you keep up the good work exposing Philip to a variety of words and continue to encourage him to use new words when telling stories. A wonderful resource for developing a child's language skills is the website ABC Mouse. This resource allows you to have a trial period to see if you like it before signing up. It has many different activities which will help introduce children to many new words, form letters, and begin understanding sounds.
How do you feel like your observation of Philip went overall?
I am confident that continuing your parenting style, as well as looking into some of the resources that are recommended, that Philip will reach his developmental milestones. Do you have any questions about anything that we talked about here today?
No, and I want to thank you very much for your time. But if you could I please get a list of the resources you've recommended to me today?
Sure. I already printed you a copy of the resources as well as the developmental checklist I use for observing. Thank you for allowing me the opportunity to discuss my findings with you.